Kipe Sky here. What's going on, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. And today I want to talk to you guys about the 80 Hertz crossover setting. Is that the crossover point for your system? I'm going to go out on a limb and say no. But before we get into that, I need to get a good understanding as to what a crossover is. What is it doing? What does it do? And why is 80 Hertz maybe not the crossover setting for you? So let's start from what is a crossover. A crossover is a crossover point that allows you to cut off a certain level of frequencies to protect your speaker and allow it to perform optimally. So what do I mean? Let's say I have two bookshelf speakers and their rated frequency response is 65 Hertz all the way up to 20 kilohertz. Well, that's my frequency response. That's where the manufacturer says that my speaker is most comfortable playing. So we want to set a crossover to keep any frequencies 65 Hertz or lower from playing. Otherwise, depending the volume, you could damage your speakers playing lower frequency notes at a high volume that they're not rated for. So a crossover protects your speakers from playing below what they're rated for and passes that information to a subwoofer if you're using one. If you're not using a subwoofer, then it just cuts the frequencies off after what you set it to. So if I have two bookshelf speakers that are rated down to 65 Hertz, I probably want to set a crossover around 80 Hertz. And why is that? Well, when you have a crossover, it doesn't just stop playing those frequencies after 80 Hertz. It still plays 79, 78, 75, even 70, even 65 Hertz, but it starts to roll off every octave. So it doesn't just completely stop making audible sound. It just lowers the volume level of every frequency an octave under 80 Hertz or whatever you may have set it. So a crossover just protects your speakers to allow them to play optimally. So now that we know what a crossover is, how do we go about setting it? Well, my little rule of thumb, maybe not mine, but as I've learned through the years of home theater, a good rule of thumb is to kind of set your frequency response maybe 15 or 20 Hertz above your speaker's lowest rating. So if I have a tower speaker that's rated down to 45 Hertz, I may want to set it to 60. If I have a bookshelf that's rated to 80 Hertz, I may want to set it to 100. If I have a satellite speaker that's rated down to 90 Hertz, I may want to set it at 110. And why do I want to do this? Like I said, the crossover doesn't cut off the frequencies completely. It rolls them off if you want them to, if you have the ability to set it that way. And so they're still going to play those lower notes, but you don't want to get too close to their lowest rating, because like I said, if you turn the volume up too much, then you could cause some damage. So setting the frequencies to your speakers, it's just easiest by using what the factory says and then setting it 20 Hertz higher than what the factory says. And so you still get all the performance of that said speaker, but you know for sure that no matter how high you turn that speaker up, it's always going to be performing under its most safest environment. You're never going to turn it up too much that you could blow your speakers. You're pretty much going to be able to turn up as loud as you want to and not have any issues with over excursion, too much deep bass, whatever the case may be. So why is 80 Hertz probably not the setting for you? Well, we've kind of already touched on it. Most speakers aren't rated at 100 Hertz or 60 Hertz or 70 Hertz. There's a vast variety of frequency responses depending on what speaker you go with. And so sometimes if you put your crossover too high, you're starving your speakers of a lot of performance. Let's use my Canton Ventos for example. My speakers are rated down comfortably to around 30, 35 Hertz. And so if I set my speakers to 80, well, I just starve my speakers of a lot of performance. They're very capable of performing a little bit lower than that. And they sound really good when they do it. And so if you set your frequency response too high, then you're taking away a lot of the performance that you paid for. Sometimes it's good to set at 80 Hertz because most speakers around there can perform mid-range really well, but maybe when they get down to 60 or 50, they may sound muddy. So maybe you want to set it higher because it doesn't sound good in the lower registers, even if they're rated to go lower. Use your ear. If you have a speaker that's rated down to 55 Hertz, but after 60, it sounds kind of bad, doesn't sound very good, well, you may want to cut them off at a little higher point so that they sound a little bit better and they perform where they sound their best. But if you have big speakers that can perform down to 40 Hertz down in the basement and they sound good doing it, well, don't cut that frequency off that low. Maybe a 40 Hertz speaker should be set at 60 so it can still perform its natural range, but still be safe while it does it. What I challenge you guys to do is to go back into your manual or go to your manufacturer's website and look under the specifications and take a look at your speaker's frequency response. Each and every speaker in your home, check out the frequency response. And then once you know all of your frequencies, go to your AVR or your preprocessor, your amplifier, whatever you're using, and I want you to go in and check your crossover settings and see where they are and make some adjustments. Most of the time, people's crossovers are wrong. Go back in and see where you have your set and use what we now know today to try to fix and tailor your crossover. Now, like I said earlier in the video, use your ears. Your ears are your best tools of measurement. So if you're changing crossover and it doesn't sound good, then maybe you should leave it where you had it, or maybe raise it higher, bring it lower, whatever your ears tell you. But make sure you're playing no lower than what your speakers are rated for, just so that you don't potentially damage them during times of high volume. So go into your receiver, check your specs, and see what you have set up, and make some minor tweaks. Changing your crossover can make a huge difference in your overall sound performance. Having your crossover set too high may make your sound sound anemic, a little bit weak, not a lot of impact. Having it set too low may sound bloaty, may sound distorted, or could cause you problems in the future. So go back in and check your settings and see where you have them and make small adjustments, because it can make a big time difference. With your subwoofer, once you have all of your speakers set, you can adjust your subwoofer as well. Me personally, I have two different crossovers for my subwoofer set. I can set my low pass filter for movies, and then I can set my overall crossover. And so what this allows me to do is set my sub at 120 hertz on my low pass filter so that I can still get big impact during my movies, but when I'm watching regular TV or listening to music, it's not playing 120 hertz. It's a little bit less, but we'll talk about that in a different video. It's a whole nother entity. Don't want to get too confusing, but take your crossover, set them all on your speakers, and then set your subwoofer to match the rest of your speakers and see how it sounds. If you guys want to know more about the subwoofer crossover, I've done some videos before, but I'll make one specifically about the subwoofer because it's a little bit different in comparison to some of your main speakers that you're using. So leave me a comment down below. Let me know what speakers you're using, what are their frequency responses, and what do you have set? Let me know down below in the comment section so that anybody else who has your speakers can use some tips from you. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hit that like button and subscribe if you're not already. We will see you in the next video. K-Base Guy out. Peace.